Our first guest is the undisputed Queen Bee of rock and roll, whether as part of a rock supergroup or as an acclaimed solo artist. She has topped charts, toured the world and started both musical and style trends. But none of this would have happened had it not been for her joining one of the most famous rock and roll bands in history. You can go your own way. Please welcome, she's here, Stevie Nicks! Hello, hello, hello. Welcome. Welcome, welcome. It is lovely, lovely to have you here. Now, we mentioned there just at the top that obviously all this global success that you had may not have happened if you hadn't joined Fleetwood Mac. How did that come about, you joining the band in the first place?
Well, we had lived in Los Angeles for probably 2 to 3 years. Everybody keeps telling me I get the time wrong, so I think it's longer than it was.
Okay.
But say 2 or 3 years. And on the last night of 73, Mick Fleetwood called Lindsay and I and asked us if we wanted to join Fleetwood Mac. Mm-hmm. He had heard some of Buckingham Nicks out at a studio in the Valley in Los Angeles. And he, even though there was a girl, he had already talked to the producer who said you're not going to get him without her. So.
Okay.
And they made the decision, you know, that we would all have dinner with Chris, and Christine would make the decision.
Okay.
If she and I got along, she could make the decision whether or not we would do it, because that would make two girls in the band. So it would be up to her.
Uh-huh.
And we just had the best time. We went out for Mexican food, and we had a great time. And we went into rehearsal 2 days later.
And it was what, about a year after that rumors came out. Is that right?
No.
How long after that?
It seems like, you know, that was the first record. So we went right into rehearsal. We rehearsed for 6 weeks. We went right into recording, where we were getting paid $200 a week apiece and then $400 a week apiece. So we went from starving poor to hugely rich. And, I mean, for us,
yeah.
Hugely
rich. Yeah.
So we went into the studio. We did the record. It came out in, like, June. And this was Fleetwood Mac. Came out in June. We went on the road, July, August, September. When we got home, Lindsay and I were together a millionaire. So I gave notice in a restaurant the first week of January.
You were working in a restaurant at the same time?
Yeah.
Wow.
And I'm practical because I've been supporting Lindsay and our friend Richard for 3 years, you know, really, because what were they going to do?
Wow. Stevie, that was back in 75, 76, and since then the band split up, got back together again, and you've made loads of very, very successful solo albums. And now the band's back on tour. How do you talk to each other after all these years? Are there things that you agree not to talk about?
Well, actually, we're getting along probably better than we ever have, and I think that's why this tour is so successful.
Yeah.
Because about a year and a half ago, I had a talk with Lindsay.
Yeah.
I had the everything I wanted to say to you for 35 years.
Oh, brilliant. How long did it take, Stevie?
And I started 1968.
Yeah.
And this was only a year and a half ago. And I worked up from before we ever even moved to San Francisco to L.A.
Yeah.
I started with, he cut my fingernail off once because he decided that I should practice guitar more. That was not a good move on his part.
Uh-huh.
And we went from there all the way up until now, until a year and a half ago. And I said, you know, do you remember how funny and sweet we were? Do you remember how cute we were? Do you remember how when we walked in the room, we were a power couple? The loving thing that we gave out? And do you know how long it's been since we have not been that power couple? And if we're going to do this again, we have got to go back to
what did he say?
He was very quiet.
I'll bet he was.
He was. It was a solid hour and a half where I never stopped talking.
Stevie, how do you think you were able to do that? What? Because that's most people would just not be able to face each other, work together ever again. What's so special?
Well, I just said, We should work together again.
Professional
we should.
Respect.
What do we have? We worked from 68 till 75, you and I, in a band by ourselves, killing ourselves. Mm-hmm. Yeah. We, you know, and then we joined Fleetwood Mac and worked from 1975 until the talk was 2011. Until 2011, and so what are we going to just throw that all out the window and just go off and do our own thing and never? Is this just going to end because we can't forgive each other for all those years?
Yeah.
So I think we need to forgive each other, and now it's the ball is in your court.
So right now, is it still? Do you still feel excited by it as you did then? Has it come to a point where you
well,
go?
Well, it's much
wow.
better now.
There you go.
Since the talk, everything's much better. Now we walk on stage and we're holding hands and we look at each other and we are actually communicating with each other on stage, and people are getting to see that, you know,
because an audience can tell
if
you're
faking it.
And
to see me go like that, you know, and they're seeing it and they love it, and of course I love it because it makes me feel like everything we do wasn't for nothing. I mean, yes, was it for making a lot of money? Yes, great, but in the, you know, when you're 90 years old and you're in your last year and you're looking back over your life, you're not so much going to say, well, I made this much money. You're going to say, then there was this moment, and then there was this fabulous moment, and then there was that moment when we walked on stage and we told the story about when you and I lost the song and it got and somebody stole it, and then we just found it on YouTube in 2010. And it's like, and Lindsay laughs and says to me, and I said, is the story too long? And he goes, I think it's charming.
Well, Stevie,
do I know you?
Stevie, it's interesting.
Who are you?
It's interesting that you talk about all these golden moments, because you've got together with an absolute legend, who is Dave Stewart, and you've put a wonderful film together. We've got, before we ask you a bit about it, we have got a little bit of you lay just to show you. This is the two of you just basically looking back at the awesome career that both of you have had.
This is the most fun thing I ever did in my life. This is the best year of my life.
What exactly are people going to get out of this film?
I think that you're going to love it, because it's a year at my house, and you're going to get to...
When did you do
You're
going to
make
this,
in 2010.
Yeah. So we're going to see inside your house.
You are.
You let a camera
every day for 10 months.
Why did you decide to do that? Because you're
wanted
notoriously
to leave it
private.
Behind. I wanted to have something sacred to leave behind
That's
to all
very
the
brave.
Little... All the little rock stars that would be and come behind us.
And obviously, obviously we're seeing all the clips there of some iconic moments throughout your life and career. You know, you are the original rock and roll star. There are youngsters who've obviously, that have, I mean, Taylor Swift for one, that said she's been absolutely influenced by your career. I've heard say that you would love the ones who are slightly coming off the rails just to listen to you a little bit more. What sort of advice would you like to give the ones who are losing their way?
Well, without wasting any of your time up here, I think that people will be sorry. I'm going to use Miley Cyrus as an example, because I happen to really like her.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I happen to think that she, unlike some of the other rock and roll slash actresses that we are always worried about, I think Miley has the possibility and ability to become a great actress and a great singer and probably a great songwriter and go on until she's my age. I think that she will not be very happy with what just went down 2 weeks ago. Mm-hmm. And I think that when you're really young, you don't think about even 10 years from now or 5 years from now. And I actually didn't either, you know, but I was more, I was really focused on who I wanted to be and what I wanted to be. Yeah. And I knew I was going to be in this business for a long time. And I wasn't interested in writing songs about, I'm just going to party, 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 and I don't care if anybody likes it. That's just what I'm going to do, because I'm just going to party, party, party. And I'm like, you know what? That's what everybody is singing about. And it's going to get very, very boring very fast to everybody. Mm. So you better think of something else to write about.
Mm. Which is exactly why you are still here today. And you are so awesome.
Thank you.
Which is a wonderful place to run. Stevie, thank you so much. Before we go, just say that The End of Dreams premieres on Monday. It's available on DVD from November. And the European leg, the Fleetwood Mac 2013 World Tour, it opens on the 20th.
And the premiere
September.
Is Monday, everybody.
It is Monday.
If you can see it. It's really important.
All right. Right after the break.